Good evening, everyone. Thanks for joining us for News 3 Now at 10. I'm Leah Lynchide. Widespread severe weather across our area tonight. Tornado touchdowns, hundreds still without power, and the chance for more storms still to come this weekend. We have team coverage tonight. Brad Hamilton is in Grant County with the worst of the damage. But we want to start with Austin Kopnitsky and your certified most accurate forecast. Austin, we have another alert day in the forecast.
Yeah, we do. Another alert day for tomorrow. And our alert day for tonight still hasn't expired as we are still tracking some of those showers and thunderstorms. Now, for most of us, we saw those strong to severe thunderstorms racing through the area, and then we've seen a little bit of a break period. But now what we're tracking next is that potential for a second line that's trying to develop here just up to our north. Notice how this keeps on trying to inch backwards as it also races off to the east and continues to the southeast as well. Right now, Oshkosh getting hammered by some heavy downpours, quite a bit of some thunder and lightning as well. But again, this continues to track off to the east, so hopefully this should not be an issue for too much longer, but some of our northern communities still may end up potentially seeing another strong, maybe even marginally severe thunderstorm. We still have that slight risk of severe weather for tonight, and then for tomorrow, we're looking at a marginal risk for severe weather. Now, temperatures really have fallen where we saw quite a bit of the rainfall, 70 degrees in Madison, but look where it generally stayed drier. They saw less of the rainfall. Still those upper 70s. So what does this mean here for our rain chances later on tonight? And what about a look at the extended forecast? I'll have all your answers coming up here in just a little moment.
Austin, thank you very much. Now, Boscobel is seeing some of the worst damage tonight. Emergency management crews report several homes and barns are gone after a tornado touchdown just outside of city limits. Brad Hamilton is in Grant County tonight. He continues our live coverage. Brad, what are you seeing?
Yeah, Leah, everything in Grant County right now is pretty quiet, but before it was far different. We actually got a chance to speak with a woman who I'm going to actually have some video pulled up right now, who had her barn completely wiped out. You're going to be seeing images here of what remains of a barn that has been in her family since 1967 when they moved there. Now, she says the barn itself was built in 1910, and when you just drove into Boscobel, you could see all the damage, and I should correct myself, just the outskirts of Boscobel. It was really like a scene out of a movie. It was very surreal. You were just seeing parts of barns scattered everywhere and just people trying to collectively collect themselves and see what remains of their property. Now, this woman who is probably, I'm guessing here, but in her 80s, she says that she was inside her home with her husband at the time of this, and she said that they were not hurt. And we saw a little bit of damage to the house, but fortunately, she said she hadn't heard of any injuries herself from the area. Now, it's a small town where, you know, everyone's trying to talk together, but so far, we haven't heard of any injuries in the area where that tornado touched down and really just blew away their barn. And she said, you know, it's a total loss, and it's something that's crushing. I mean, it's been in that family for a long time now. We saw family coming in from different parts and talked to one of the sons who said, you know, I was born in this home, and it really, you could just see how much it was impacting people, and really a lot of people just feeling lucky to have their lives at this point. And you know, it's going to be one of those things that we're going to keep updating you as we get more information. You know, right now we're still piecing it together as power outages, things of that nature, are still really affecting this area. And Leah, I'm going to be coming back to you in a little bit here, but that's all we have for right about now. But we'll keep you up to date with the latest as we hear more.
Just incredible video out of Grant County, thinking of those families tonight. Brad, thank you very much. Now, power outages still active in parts of Grant County at this hour. You're taking a live look at the numbers on Alliant Energy's website right now. About 300 people in Boscobel are still without power. That number was at 1,200 customers without power this afternoon. The estimated time of restoration, though, not until 5 a.m. Emergency crews in Grant County are also asking people to stay off the roads. There are downed power lines all across that area. We've seen crews cleaning them up live all night long. Again, restoration for that power not expected until 5 a.m. Now, the photos from viewers just keep coming in tonight, just stunning pictures here of the skies, of damage, of some of the sunsets we've seen. There's some 2-inch big hail out in Highland. You might see a picture of that in here. Just stunning, stunning photos. There's Highland as well. If you have any pictures or videos you were able to safely take of today's storms, we would love to see them. You can send them to our newsroom by emailing tips@channel3000.com or posting them to our Facebook page. Now, tonight's the night you're going to want to keep your First Warn weather app close by. We're going to be sending out any push alerts on severe weather expected overnight and into your Sunday. We're making it easy for you to download. Take out your phone camera and point it at your screen right now, at this QR code. That's going to take you right to your app store to download it. You can download your app at any time. Just search First Warn weather app. Now, the weather even impacting the Packers' return to Lambeau Field. The start to family night had to be pushed back because of storms in the Fox Valley. Didn't stop fans from celebrating the green and gold, though. Adam Duxter explains why this year's event meant more to those faithful fans.
Well, the weather isn't the greatest, and it's technically not even a real game, but the football is back, and so are the fans here at Lambeau Field, and that alone is enough reason for celebration here in Green Bay. The sizzle of the grill and the drop of the bag all mean one thing.
Rain, shine, it doesn't matter. Football is back. We miss football during COVID and stuff, so family night is an opportunity to get together with fans and enjoy football again, and that's a big deal.
Tonight's practice is about celebrating family, and for fans of the green and gold, that goes deeper than blood.
We're here to hang out.
It's just that camaraderie.
Oh, it's just awesome.
It's insane, but it's just a great community that we have here.
And the start of this season marks a sigh of relief even for the youngest of fans.
Who's your favorite player on the Packers?
Aaron Rodgers.
Were you afraid he was going to go to another team?
Yes.
Ultimately, the score tonight won't count for anything, but for the thousands in attendance,
make sure you have seen it.
Being back together is a win in itself.
I think it's the Midwest culture. I think if you're Midwest, you appreciate spending time with people that just want to hang out and have common likenesses. We don't have to agree. Maybe some of us disagree. We're all going to have fun, though.
Adam Duxter, News 3 Now.
Now, fans did have to take shelter in the concourse before the start of the event. Not for long, though. They were back in their seats within half an hour of the start time. 10:07 now, we are following a developing story out of the nation's capital tonight. The Senate clearing a key hurdle on the president's bipartisan infrastructure bill. That means it could get to the House as soon as tomorrow.
3/5 of the senators duly chosen and sworn having voted in the affirmative, the motion is agreed to.
Now today, the Senate voted 67-27 to end debate on the $1 trillion bill. One more vote does need to happen to send the legislation to the House before it can head to the president for his signature. President Biden throwing his support behind the bill on Twitter this morning. He called the deal a historic, once-in-a-generation investment in our nation's infrastructure, going on to say we can't afford not to do it. To our school coverage now, enrollment for the Madison School District is now open. You can register your child at the school district's website. Right now, the process is entirely virtual, but if you need help, you can call or email the district's enrollment office during business hours. We have all that information up right now on channel3000.com. The State Department of Health is updating its guidelines for preventing the spread of COVID in the classroom. A main part of the new recommendations is getting eligible kids ages 12 and up vaccinated. The DHS is also launching its testing toolkit program. More than 300 districts have already signed up. Masks are not required in schools statewide, but the DHS and state superintendent are recommending them. And a look tonight at Wisconsin's COVID numbers. For the first time since February, the 7-day average of COVID cases is topping 1,000 statewide. Dane County, though, not behind that spike. Numbers here are going up, but the latest data from public health shows the 7-day average is at 55 cases. Health experts believe that's because the vaccination rate in the county, just under 70%, is well above the national average, right at 50.
Definitely think that our shield of vaccination protection is very high in Dane County. So I do think that contributes to the level of increase that we're seeing. The levels would be much higher, certainly, if there were fewer people vaccinated.
Public health data also shows 93% of Dane County's new cases last month were the highly contagious Delta variant. Now, nationally, 50% of the U.S. population is fully vaccinated, but the 7-day average for new cases now higher than 100,000. That's the first time since the winter surge that we've seen those numbers. As recently as late June, the country was averaging about 11,000 cases each day. New cases peaked at about 250,000 daily in early January. New tonight at 10, two people are dead following a crash in Dodge County. It happened on Highway 151 in Beaver Dam around 2 this afternoon. Sheriff deputies say one car was driving the wrong way in an inside lane and hit another car head on. Southbound lanes on Highway 151 were shut down for more than 3 hours. And you might notice flags around the state are at half staff today. It's in honor of former State Major General Albert Wilkening, buried today in Oregon. Wilkening had a long career of service in the U.S. military. He commanded the Wisconsin National Guard from 2002 to 2007. He died in April. Wilkening was 74 years old. 1010 now. It's been more than 3 years since a Madison staple closed its doors. But coming up, how you can still get another taste of Ella's Deli right in your own kitchen. But first, a live update on the damage after tonight's storms and the severe weather we're watching for the rest of your weekend. That's still ahead.